Welcome. In this video, we are going to learn the difference between relative and absolute cell addresses in Excel. By the end of the video, you will understand the difference between relative and absolute cell addresses, and you will understand when to use each of them. So let's get started. You can see by looking at the spreadsheet in front of you that we are keeping track of sales figures for six salespeople in the Dallas area for this company. We're looking at sales figures for the month of July, and we have them separated by week. And then at the end here, we have a total for each salesperson for the month of July. Also, along the bottom here in row 12, we have totals by week for the entire sales force, as well as a total for the month. So our goal over here is to determine what percentage of this total is represented by each individual salesperson in terms of their sales. We're going to begin with Alan Brooks. I'm going to come up here and enter a formula. And I'm going to put my equal sign in, and I'm going to look at Alan's total sales, and I want to divide that by the total of all salespeople for the month. So I'm going to click here in cell F12. When I press enter, I can see that Alan Brooks represents 27.56% of the total sales for the month of July. Now I basically want to do the same thing for the remaining five salespeople. So I can come up here. And as you know, Excel has a fill handle that allows me to copy what I've done in one cell to other cells. So I'm going to grab this and just drag it straight down for the remaining five salespeople and release my mouse. The problem is when I do that, I get an error. So let's go take a look at what happened. Notice when I put my first formula in, everything looks great. I come up here to the formula bar, I can see that I divided F6 by F12. When I go to John Davis's formula, the F7 is correct because it grabbed his total for the month of July, but it divided it instead by a blank cell, F13, instead of dividing it by the July total in F12. That's because we used a relative cell address in our formula here. F6 and F12 are both relative cell addresses, and a relative cell address is one that changes when a formula is copied relative to where it's being copied. So as I copied this down, you can see both parts of the formula up here on the formula bar changed as I filled down or copied down. That's great for the first half of the formula, but it's not what we wanted for the second half of the formula, the F12. We want that to stay the same as we fill down. So instead of using a relative cell address for our second half of the formula, the F12, we're going to use what's called an absolute cell address. And an absolute cell address is one that remains the same even when the formula is copied. The way that we let Excel know we want to change that cell address to an absolute cell address is we come up to the formula bar, and the easiest way to do it is to click in front of that cell address. And if you look on your keyboard, you'll see a row at the top of function keys. They are the letter F preceded or followed rather by a number. If I press the F4 function key, that is automatically going to insert dollar signs in front of both my column and my row. And what that does, those dollar signs tell Excel, as this formula is being filled down, do not change this cell address. So you can see that the first part of this formula is a relative cell address. In other words, one that is going to change when we fill down. And the second half is an absolute cell address, which is one that's going to remain the same. So now I'm going to just do that fill, grab that fill handle again and do the same thing I did a little while ago. And now I have what looks to be the correct answers. So let's check it out. We'll click here in cell G7 and we'll look up at the formula bar. We can see that the front part of the formula did change from F6 to F7, but F12 did not change this time to F13. It stayed at F12 because we changed it to an absolute cell address with our dollar signs. That is the same for each of the other cells, and you can see as I move down, you can look at the formula bar and see how the front half changed, the back half did not change. So it's a nice easy way to put in a formula such as this where I can actually get a quick snapshot of where each of the salespeople fall in terms of total sales. So in summary, a relative cell address is one that changes when the formula is copied. An absolute cell address is one that remains the same when the formula is copied. We identify to Excel an absolute address by inserting dollar signs in front of both the row and the column. We can do that using our function key F4, or we can do it manually by inserting them ourselves. Thank you.